think of medicines, chances are that these will come to mind rather than these. What you might not realize is that a lot of the time, potential drugs and other really useful compounds come from some truly bizarre places in nature. Today we're looking at why these three unlikely animals might just save your life one day. Welcome to the remote island of Komodo in southeast Indonesia, home to the largest lizard on Earth, the Komodo dragon. When hunting, these apex predators often rely on the 57 or more types of dangerous bacteria residing in their saliva to kill their prey. Even though their bacterial bite can take down animals as large as a buffalo, the dragons themselves seem to be totally resistant to these deadly bacteria, which drew the attention of scientists. While studying this immune defense in the blood of dragons, they discovered a peptide called VK25. They predicted that it defended against infections from bacterial biofilms like the ones found in other dragons' deadly spit. Biofilms are collections of microorganisms that stick together and coat a surface, making it hard to remove slime. When bacterial biofilms form in humans, they're nearly impossible to treat. The VK25 peptide was used as a model to help build a new synthetic peptide called DRGN1. In mice, this peptide was highly effective in treating common bacterial strains that cause pneumonia and even staph infection. But sometimes staph infections can get a bit out of hand. So out of hand, in fact, that we may have no way to treat them. A dangerous strain called MRSA is an infamous superbug that kills upwards to 11,000 Americans each year. MRSA creates a seemingly impenetrable biofilm that's highly resistant to antibiotics. So are we in big trouble? Maybe not if this humble little sponge has anything to do with it. Meet the Antarctic sea sponge, Dendrilla membranosa. This little sub-zero loving periphera has recently been under the microscope for its incredible resilience to bacterial infection. The sponges are armed with a really promising compound called darwinolide. When tested on strains of MRSA, this chemical had knockout level antibacterial efficiency and has shown great promise as becoming one of the first ever antibiotics against biofilms. Now, obviously, it isn't easy to send barges down to the Antarctic to fish a bunch of sea sponges to bring back to be used as medicine, so the icing on the cake here, folks, is that a synthesis of this molecule is already underway in the lab. But this, of course, isn't all that oceanic life has to offer. The 400-million-year-old horseshoe crab has been a workhorse in medicine for almost 50 years. When you're older than the dinosaurs, you better believe you'll have some evolutionary tricks up your sleeve, and in this case, look no further than their freaky-looking blood. Horseshoe crab blood gets its blue hue from the copper and hemocyanin, rather than our hemoglobin-filled iron red blood. But what's really fascinating is its highly effective immune defense against bacteria. Cells in the blood, known as amebocytes, release proteins that form a gel barrier around any invading bacteria, which stops them in their tracks. Starting in the late 1960s, scientists realized that they could extract a fluid from the amebocytes that could form this gel. There are two types of fluid collected from horseshoe crabs, LOL from the Atlantic and TAL from the Pacific. We're going to focus on LOL here. Turns out LOL doesn't have to be in a crab to work. Anytime it sees toxic molecules hanging from bacteria like E. coli, it clumps around them. So LOL is used to check medical instruments, medicines, or vaccines we inject into ourselves for potentially harmful bacterial byproducts. Squirt some LOL juice into a sample of flu vaccine, if there's no clumping, you're clear to inject that batch into people. These crabs are literally saving our lives. For this reason, one quart of blood can run a bill of up to $15,000. So as you might expect, with liquid gold of this caliber, the LOL industry has exploded. 500,000 horseshoe crabs are bled each year at milking stations. These milk crabs are then later released, but studies suggest that 8-10% of the crabs die when returned. This on top of overfishing and other environmental factors have made this species vulnerable to extinction, which is bad news. Because of this, chemists are trying to come up with synthetic versions of LOL and TAL so we can leave our ancient friends alone. So there is a lesson in all this, folks, and it's loud and clear. We need to do everything we can to protect nature and to keep our planet healthy. Saving the Earth's ecosystems doesn't just mean saving all kinds of plants and animals. Those exotic plants and animals might save your life too, and who knows what other life-saving compounds are out there. So make sure that you're doing your part, and hit thumbs up and subscribe on the way out. We'll see you again soon.